These are the first 100 homes being lit up under the Electricity Access Scale-Up project. It targets 1 million connections, covering households, industrial parks and refugee settlements, among others. During the launch, the Minister for Energy and Mineral Development, Ruth Nankabirwa, noted that the project will also positively impact the environment, employing solar technologies to reduce dependence on biomass.
I am in charge of connecting power and improving the use of power, especially in green cooking. Therefore, as I develop the petroleum sector, I am mindful of the fact that the gas that is associated with the petroleum, which by the way we have started drilling and we have reached in Itilenga, 25 wells have been reached, and on the Kingfisher side, 11 wells have been reached, and they are very promising. And therefore we are going to start seeing the associated gas coming out.
Nankabirwa assured Ugandans that the government will continue to expand the transmission and distribution infrastructure by constructing power lines and substations. The transmission network has increased from 1,132 kilometers in 2005 to current 4,355 kilometers, while the distribution network length has increased from 6,496 kilometers in 2005 to the current 76,922 kilometers.
As we speak, we have expanded the backbone of electricity. That means that connectivity is going to be easier. And government has come out to help you on connectivity. Power is not going to be free, but to help you to connect. I've seen homes where they are next to a pole, but somebody is still in that place. That means it is not cheap to connect power.
On his part, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayebwa, who is also the MP for Rohingya North constituency, hailed NRM government and all development partners for what he termed as a game-changer project which will improve livelihoods of Ugandans. 70% of this constituency is connected to electricity, but he appealed to the ministry to sort out the problem of load shedding.
We have been finding it difficult to explain to people who have no electricity that we have excess electricity, to be every financial year to be appropriating hundreds of billions to pay for electricity which is not consumed. It's been painful, extremely painful. So I'm loving this initiative, because electricity we have been paying for without consuming is now going to be consumed.
It's going to be a game changer in the region and the country at large. People are yearning for services, and by the fact that you have launched it, Honorable Minister, we are very grateful, and as members of Parliament, we are going to continue supporting you.
Meanwhile, the Energy Ministry also launched a partnership with Delight to supply solar equipment in off-grid power areas at 50%, where half is contributed by the government and the half by the beneficiary.
So Mazda offered to do the study. And they are here, they are going to do the study. That means we, Zilia, the CEO who regulates, is going to unlock this, and we are going to see many more licenses being issued. And so that means we are going to see much more power generated. You can't distribute what you don't have.
We have partnered with the government of Uganda under the Ministry of Energy so that we can bring solar next to you. So government is subsidizing, so I'm calling upon all customers out there. Come find Delight solar products, come buy.
Some of the beneficiaries of the Electricity Access Scale-Up project expressed excitement, and they thanked the government for the initiative. We are so happy at last we have got electricity. We have been going through a lot of problems with solar, which was not reliable. We are so grateful for this project. We have been in darkness, but now the whole place is lighting. The project is largely going to help our children revising their books at night and perform well. Electricity Access Scale-Up project is a Government of Uganda flagship project whose development objective is to increase access to electricity to all Ugandans. The project will be delivered to the tune of $638 million or 2.2 trillion shillings in partnership with the World Bank. Story compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.